Hi, welcome back to the channel. It's Jim. It's still Wednesday. Well, certainly here it is. I don't know what it is where you are. It may be Tuesday next week or Sunday in a month's time. Who knows? But certainly when I'm recording this, it's Wednesday afternoon and I'm moving forward with part two. Part two of Act One of Joe's Garage from Frank Zappa. Now, I've got over myself. I'm sorry if you were. I was just a bit shocked on side one from the lyrical content. I've had a word with myself. Look, Jim, it's of a different time. It's art. It's an expression. It's a story. It's not real. It's fine. So I'm not going to redo the video. So I'm sorry. It's it is what it is. But let's move swiftly onwards to side two. So it's musically, this is absolutely brilliant, and it is actually a pretty good story, even though the choice of language is perhaps not wouldn't stand up to scrutiny, doesn't stand up to scrutiny in 2022. But you know, this was 1979. So what do we have now? We've got four more songs. We've got Wet T-Shirt Night. Hey, that's fine, isn't it? Toad O'Line, Why Does It Hurt When I Pee? Who knows? And Lucille Has Messed My Mind Up. So all perfectly good, harmless, happy fun songs that we should be cracking on with. It is what it is, Jimothy. It is what it is. The disc is turned over. Everything is recording. Let's crack on. Side 2, Joe's Garage. Let's inspect those wet t-shirts.
This is the central scrutinizer again. And so, Harry was enticed away from Joe by an evil barbarian with a wrench in his pocket. Lured into a life of sleazery with the entire road crew of some famous rock group. I don't know whether it was really tough or not. I'll check it out. Again, we see music causing
too much for the beer. And they all think they're clean out of sight. And they're ready to party, cause the sun outside said it's wet t-shirt night. And they all praise him a happy life. Well, the girls are excited because in a minute they're gonna get wet. And the boys are delighted because all the titties will get them upset. And they all think they're really alright. It's wet t-shirt night, and they all praise some pink light.
This is really cool. You hear this sort of sound quite a lot in things like Dream Theater and Haken, paying homage to Zappa, obviously.
Whoa. When the water gets on them, the ninnies get rigid and look pretty bold. It's a common reaction, it makes an attraction whenever it's cold. And all the fellas, they whisper goodbye. It's the local girls are showing off tonight. You know I think it serves them right. You know I think it serves them right. You know I think it serves them right. You know I think it it serves them right. And it's wet t-shirt time again. I know you want someone to show you some tips.
Ah, thanks. I guess it's wet t-shirt time again. Here at the Brasserie, home of the tits. And it's the charming Mary from Canoga Park up next in her bid for the semifinals. Hi, Mary. How you doing?
Hi.
Where are you from?
The bus.
Which one?
You know, the last tour. Leather.
Oh, you were the girl that was stuck to seat 38 on Fido 3. Why don't you get in position now and take a deep breath? Because this water is very, very cold, but it's going to be so stimulating. And Mary's the kind of red-blooded American girl who'll do anything. I said anything for $50. That's right.
I really need the $50. You know, I gotta get home.
Yeah, I know. Your father is waiting for you in the tool shed. That's right. You heard right. Our big prize tonight is $50 to the girl with the most exciting mammalian protuberances.
Here I am.
As viewed through a thoroughly soaked, stupid-looking, white sort of male person's conservative kind of middle-of-the-road cotton undergarment, whoopee! And here comes the water! No, you'd squeak more if the water got... Sounds like you just got an ice pick in the forehead. And here comes the ice pick in the forehead! Million laughs, Mary. Anyway... Good golly, what a mess. She's totally soaked.
Total, I love it.
Yeah, totally committed to the $50. That's it. Just step into the spotlight. Let the guys get a good look at you, honey. What do you say, fellas? Nice set of jugs? Now, Mary, how's about shaking it around a little?
Ooh,
oh, my goodness, look at her go.
I'm dancing.
Ain't this what living is really all about? Here's your $50, Mary.
Oh, great. Now I can go home.
Woo! Home is where the heart is.
On the bus.
An amazing tone on that guitar. I got the drummer wrong on the side one. It's not Ed Manitoy's percussion. Vinny Colata, the drummer, doing a great job. Thank you. Can we just say what an amazing piece of guitar playing that was?
About Mary's body exploits. He falls in with a vast crowd and gets seduced by a girl who works at the Jack in the Box named Lucille, who gives him an unpronounceable
wonder.
I don't wanna die, cause there's no needle in me. Why does it hurt when I bleed? I got it from the toilet seat. I got it from the toilet. My bones feel like a pair of maracas. Ay, ay, ay. Why does it, why does it, why does it, why does it
This is actually quite hysterical.
Young got me.
This sounds so good.
She doesn't answer when I call her on the phone. She messed up my mind. I'm crying all of the time.
Play guitar to some sort of acceptable level. Figured he'd come back into it again.
Hi, it's me again, the Central Scrutinizer. Joe says Lucille has messed his mind up. But was it the girl or was it the music? As you can see, girls, music, disease, heartbreak, they all go together. Joe found out the hard way, but his troubles were just beginning. His mind was so messed up, he could hardly do nothing. He was in a quandary, being devoured by the swirling cesspool of his own steaming desires. The guy was a wreck. So, what does he do? For once, he does something smart. He goes out and pays a lot of money to L. Ron Hoover.
What is appliantology?
Oh, my life. There we go.
We did it. Or I did it. I got through it. Side two of Joe's Garage, Act One. Actually, you know, having come to sort of just look, Jim, just take it with a pinch of salt. Take it for what it is. I'm enjoying this a lot more. I mean, I didn't not enjoy it the first side. That's completely not what I meant by that. But I was shocked. I think that's kind of the point. And this is bloody brilliant music. Really, really good. Can we just talk about that Todo line? The second track on here. What an epic guitar solo that was. Now, I wonder if this is part of that thing I was saying about earlier on. I think it was on the first video, actually. I might have lost it now. Joe's Garage. Here we go. I was talking about xenochrony. So, xenochrony, a recording technique that takes a musical material, in this instance, guitar solos, from older live recordings and overdubs them onto different unrelated material. So I wonder if this is one of those examples. I don't, where it came from, I don't know. But it fitted. It didn't feel out of place at all. The whole of this side is just remarkably, remarkably good. That last song as well, Lucille Has Messed My Mind Up, had me sort of thinking a little bit of Moments from the Wall from Pink Floyd. Just the sort of really quiet, the way the echo is on the clean guitar. It's magnificent. I mean, it really is. And I do apologise about my take on the first side, because I guess I was not quite prepared for it and not ready for it. But I know this is from a different time. It's from a different era. And it's a story. It's a work of fiction. So don't hate me for that. You can if you want, I don't care. You can hate me. I can only be me, can't I? And as I listen to something for the first time, a reaction is going to be literally that. It is how I reacted to hearing this for the first time. So he's a clever old boy, though. There's Frank Zappa. He's a clever chap. And he's got an absolutely stellar group of musicians around him to produce this. The bass work on here... everything. I can't really single anything out. The guitar and the guitar, which is obviously Frank Zappa himself, the bass and the drums are absolutely standout, supremely good. But again, the keyboards are as well. Everything is just right. Everything is just right. We had saxophones on here. We've got everything, and it's brilliant. It's brilliant. So I am absolutely going to be listening to Acts 2 and Acts 3. I'm not going to do it immediately. It'll be coming up in the next few weeks, months. I don't know when I get to it. I do hope that you've enjoyed this video. I've enjoyed it a lot more the second time than I did on side one. And I sort of go away from this feeling less anxious about what I've just listened to. So I hope you've enjoyed it, and I'll see you on the next video. Whatever that is, whenever it is, I don't know. Who does? Certainly not me, because I kind of make it up as I go along. But I'll see you on the next video, whenever and whatever that is. And until then, this is Jim over, and...